Hey, everybody, thanks for coming to the house today. We really appreciate it. This is going to be a lot of fun today, a lot of really cool music, and a few surprises as well. Please welcome Barenaked Ladies. Thanks for coming, gentlemen.
Oh, George.
How are you feeling?
Amazing.
You're a Hall of Famer.
Yeah, it's amazing, man. As I was saying to you downstairs, I feel like we won the lottery several times over, and now we're just getting a plaque to remind us that we won the lottery. So it's a pretty amazing thing.
Are you a reflective bunch by nature?
I wouldn't say we're... reflective to me sounds a bit melancholy. We are constantly reminiscing about ridiculous things that have happened to us over the years and great things that have happened to us over the years. Yeah. And certainly, you know what? The Canadian tour we just did, I think, made us more nostalgic than even this Hall of Fame award. It's just, you know, going across the prairies in the winter, you start thinking about the first time you ever did that. Yeah. And it was a huge tour and the longest Canadian tour we'd done in probably 20 plus years. So that made us, I would say, quite nostalgic, and that was fun. The Hall of Fame award just seems like this amazing signpost in the road that we're looking forward to driving right past and just continuing to rock.
Staying on.
Signpost right between like Grand Prairie and Lethbridge.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming today.
Thank you.
Shall we play a song? We'll just play songs and talk and just roll with it. Yeah.
All right. Cool. We were shining like aurora borealis, like Sid sipping from the Stanley chalice, balling in a bus across the USA, dumb enough to think that it could stay that way. Lounging in the living room in long johns, more distant than Victoria to St. John's, trying to use a record to repair my heart. I'd be lying if I said I didn't want to start again. My friend, you're leaving me high and Canada dry. I'm out of your head and I'm losing my mind. Listening to Neil is making me cry. You're leaving me high and Canada dry. Sinking like a Saskatoon sunset, thinking that we had it from the outset. Well, Tommy said that life was a highway, dear, but I became the roadkill when you oversteered. Oh, why? Oh, why? You're leaving me high and Canada dry. I'm out of your head and I'm losing my mind. Listening to Joni's making me cry. You're leaving me high, high and Canada dry. You fled the snow while I stayed here. I'll let you know, I'll make it clear how happy I appear. High in Canada dry, I'm out of your head and I'm losing my mind. Listening to Gord is making me cry. You're leaving me high.
That's all in it, in those lyrics right there. Right, that moment of just connecting to everything that made you who you are.
Yeah. Yeah, man, it's kind of a melancholy love song to this place we love. And on the record, it's got Alan Doyle and Jim Cuddy singing backups.
Some other things that we love.
Yeah. Do you now just, there may not be specifics, but which Joni song and which Neil song and which Gord and which Gord song?
I think we each have our own.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a little nod to Tom Cochran in there,
that's
too.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. That's right.
For me, the Joni song is probably Case of You, famously covered by Sloan. Love their version of that song. The sound of one Chris clapping.
I got to go with the river.
That's Rivers.
Amazing song. Yeah. I would go Coyote, just because of Jaco Pastorius.
No regrets, Coyote.
March, Bodorge, March, Dodibido, Dubutufruin, Dubutufruin. Yeah, awesome.
Gord is Gord.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
And I think for the whole band, it would be Coke Machine Glow.
Right, well, and there's the man behind you, Kevin Hearn, who knows that all so well, right?
We played Chancellor here last time we were here, right?
That's right.
Yeah. That's right.
That is absolutely right. Thanks. You're going to play some new songs tonight, but also you're just going to take us on a walk through some of your past stuff?
Indeed.
Do you like playing the old stuff?
Hate it. No, I...
Well, you're playing the hits tonight, bro.
As an artist, I'm just so far past this now, George, that it makes me angry. This is the great thing about being in a band, is, you know, you continue to move forward, you continue to create things, and you get to drag your whole catalog along with you. You know, I think about other art forms. Like, I'm a big fan of comedy, you know? And it's so strange to me that these comedians throw out all their amazing material and they start over and they say stuff new. We do that. We make new stuff, every year. But we have these songs that we're super proud of that we get to play. And it's this moment, not just for us, you know, for the audience and for us, this moment of celebration. Because when you guys think about when you first heard that song, so do we.
Yeah.
You know, we're up there playing these songs, and it reminds us of a time. It reminds us of a period for the band. So if we get tired of a song, we just don't play it, or we change it. We're lucky we have so many songs that we can drop something out of the set list for a while and still play a cavalcade of monster hits.
I remember... you can. Yeah. I remember when I had first heard your cover of Lovers in Dangerous Time. And thought, wow, this is another level now. Do you remember what it was like, the decision to do that song? And because that's totally.
It's funny, because it was a tribute record to Bruce Coburn, put out by Trepid Records in 1991. And we were trying to figure out what song to do. And I think I was probably the biggest Coburn fan in the band at the time. So I had, everybody knew the hits that he'd had in the last little while. If I had a Rocket Launcher, Lovers in a Dangerous Time, Trouble with Normal, things like that. I wanted to do like some early folk song. And then everybody was like, why don't we just do the song we know? And it was Lovers in a Dangerous Time. And when we were in the studio, it was interesting because there was a guy there from the record label. We were kind of struggling with the arrangement and stuff. He really wanted us to do the straight ahead version like the original. And I remember him saying, what about it like a drum feel like... Oh, you mean exactly like the original?
I think that just galvanized us to do our own version.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, and then
we ended up
Yeah, we ended up doing that and filming the cheapest video in Canadian music history, I believe. Yeah. $11,000.
Yeah.
And shot in Scarborough. And
Tim Hamilton, right?
Yeah, then there you go. No, it was in Scarborough, not in Hamilton.
Tim Hamilton, director.
Joey Scarborough, believe it or not, I'm walking on air.
Well, you want to play?
Yes.
Let's hear it.
We're going to do that. This is a song I wrote with Bruce just after.
When you were five.
Thank you. hours grow shorter as the days go by. We never get to stop and open our eyes. 1 minute you're waiting for the sky to fall. The next you're dazzled by the beauty of it all. When your lover's in a dangerous time, these fragile bodies of touch and taste, this vibrant skin, this hair like lace, spirits open to the thrust of grace. Never a breath you can't afford to waste. When your lover's in a dangerous time, your lover's in a dangerous time. Lover's in a dangerous time. Lover's in a dangerous time.
When you're doing press on this, do you have forced to go back and tell old stories for this Hall of Fame thing?
Yeah.
Do you like reliving those stories?
Sure, man.
We recirculate those stories between us all the time.
Especially if it involves someone making a mistake.
Exactly. Yeah. They last the longest.
So I remember, I think I was working in radio at the time. We knew who, of course, you guys had done the yellow tape and were really big here, but there's that moment when you go to do some college shows in the U.S. And I don't know if it was Boston, it might have been Boston, where the roads were practically shut down. Tens of thousands of people showed up. You guys thought the president was in town. And then
we were in traffic. Stop and go traffic, and we're like, what's this all about? We gotta get to our record store to play our, it was actually opening the first day of Stunt. Our record Stunt was coming to the stores. And I was sleeping in my bunk and Ed woke me up and I said, he said, I think we're in a traffic jam that's for us.
Really?
Well, Steve and I were sitting in the front lounge, and we were worried because we weren't going to get to our autograph signing and record release on time. And then I said, all these cars have B&L bumper stickers. I think we're causing this. It was pretty amazing.
You guys, I don't think you get enough credit for it. You essentially created independent music in Canada with that yellow tape.
We essentially created music in Canada.
Essentially.
Yeah.
12 bar, you guys know the 12 bar blues? That was us.
I remember Sam's and going and being able to go to that section he had, Sam the Record Man, and see like Kev's band, the Look People, was there.
They had amazing
tape,
band.
It was all tapes. Bourbon Tabernacle Choir, Rio Static.
Thanks Sloan. For the plug, Jib. Much appreciated.
Yeah. I liked, you know, Men Who Chop Trees because of the great bass slapping solo.
Clay Tyson, son of Ian Tyson.
Yeah. Well, the great thing about the cassettes, too, is that it was a 5-song cassette. And these were the days of auto-reverse cassette technology. So, you could play the same 5 songs again. You just keep it on a constant loop. It's great.
There was,
it's like the GIF of Barenaked Ladies.
There was tons of music. There was tons of indie music. What happened is when our cassette became so popular, the big chains started actually buying indie music and carrying it nationally.
Yeah.
So that was the big change. And, you know, there was a very bizarre period of time where our cassette-only release was number one, and number two was Madonna, and number three was U2.
Yeah.
And that was cool to walk into Sam the Record Man on Yonge Street and just stare at that for a while. And I did that more than once.
Speaking of which, this morning I saw for the first time the Sam the Record Man sign is back up.
It's back up.
Dundas Square. It was like another lifetime ago.
Yeah. Records, kids, are things that you used to put on a turntable. Vinyl's coming back, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
I think it's the leader in physical music sales now,
And cassettes are starting to come back, too.
Right.
Yeah, a lot of record shops, people are... Because a lot of bands can't afford to put out a vinyl, so cassettes is their way of being OG.
There you go.
Stay tuned for the player piano reel.
Nice. What do you want to play next?
I'm good, actually.
You did?
Yeah. Okay, yeah, let's
get... Should we go get some fish and
chips? You guys
chips?
Are all good. Yeah. You probably got things to do, too, George.
Yeah, but I'm home already.
Do you got some fish and chips?
I can get some. Okay. I just go upstairs and keep working while you do this.
We're going to do a song that we recorded at the long-gone gas station studios in Toronto. And I will never forget the first time Michael Philip Voivoda threw the faders up and did a rough mix, what we would call a pencil mix, of the song. And Tyler Stewart walked out onto the fire escape, and while the song played, did this at the City of Toronto. It was this, there was so much in his body language, it was like,
what does that mean?
Back. We're coming back, Canada. We've been gone a while, but we're coming back. It was a proud moment. And we don't often bring up feel-good moments. It, as Ty said, it's usually when you made a mistake, so... He called that one anyway.
Broke into the old apartment. This is where we used to live. Broken glass, broken hungry, broken hearts and broken bones. This is where we used to live. Why did you paint the walls? Why did you clean the floor? Why did you plaster over the hole I punched in the door? This is where we used to live. Why did you keep the mouse trap? Why did you keep the dish rack? Things used to be mine, I guess they still are. I want them back. Broke into the old apartment, 42 steps from the street. Crooked landing, crooked landlord, narrow laneway filled with crooks. This is where we used to live. They now is her temper this year. I turned up your TV, stomped on the floor just for fun. I know we don't live here anymore. We bought an old house on Danforth. She loves me and her body keeps me warm. I'm happy here, but this is where we used to live. I broke into the old apartment. A talk phone out of the wall. Well, only memories, fading memories, flapping into dull tableau. I won't never move back. I want them back. This is where we used to live. I want them back. This is where we used to live. I want them back. Oh, yes, yes, I want them back. I want them back.
Look at that.
Awesome. There it is.
1991. Look at that. That's amazing. It's pretty fun. All right, you want to play another song?
Yeah.
We're going to do a song that's on our first record, Gordon.
Yeah, Gordon. 26 years old.
Yeah, Gordon.
Oh, thank you. Right on.
Out on vinyl for the first time.
There it is.
Yeah. Gordon, kids is the name of a child.
Yeah, so we hadn't played this song in a long, long time. We decided to take a different approach to it, and we had a lot of fun playing it on the Canadian tour. So let's do it.
Ready? A one, a two, a one.
We never really knew each other anyway. Took me a year to believe it was over. Took me two more to get over the loss. Whoa, whoa. Well, I took a beating when you wrote me those letters. And every time I remembered the taste of your lip gloss. Come on, here we never really knew each other anyway. Here we never really knew each other anyway. Baby, we always saw other anyway, but even if we never really knew each other anyway.
There were times when I wanted to hurt you. There were times when I know that I did. Whoa, whoa. There were times when I thought I might kill you. Well, what can you blame me? I was only a kid. Tell me why we never really respected each other. Tell me why I never believed that you were a person too. I always thought that you fancied my brother. I may not have liked it, oh, but memory is a strange thing, oh. Told me to get lost. It's not fair to say that it's cause I was 3 inches shorter then. It's not fair to say that it's cause I was only 15 years old. Well, maybe it's fair to say there was a lack of communication. Took a phone message, oh, and speaking of communication, oh, Enid, Enid, you gotta go. I could get a job, I could pay the phone bills, I could get the lot, cut my hair, cut my cholesterol, I could work overtime, I could work in a mine, I could do it all for you. I don't want to, we'll never really need each other.
You know, one of the great things about you getting this Hall of Fame and this great honor is that in that same weekend for the Junos, Denise Donlan is also getting quite rightly recognized. And Denise Donlan is here today. Yeah. Denise,
I'm only here to see you guys.
It's so nice to see you, Denise.
And you.
What do you remember from the because for a lot of people, Speaker's Corner was a part where they saw the
Barenaked
Ladies.
Yeah, well, that was the cheapest Barenaked Ladies video, right?
You did it
for $1. $1.
And then there was Spring Break, right?
We did Spring Break as well. Yeah.
Right, where
early
we tried.
Days.
Yeah, and Snow Jobs, you know, where we tried to freeze all your dangly bits.
Yeah,
you know?
playing a show in a snowstorm.
Like, yeah.
Just coming right at you.
Daring avalanches to come down and take us all out. I know. We were dangerous. We lived dangerous.
Denise, I swear I watched the most tense television ever when I watched you host the Cowboy Junkies
in
Intimate
labor.
Interactive with a giant pregnant belly and in labor.
Totally in labor.
Hosting in labor, ladies and gentlemen.
My water broke 15 minutes as I was walking into the station.
Wow. Crazy.
I know. Yeah, that's awesome. That was 26 years ago, exactly.
Wow.
Yeah. But you know what I remember?
That was only 4 years into our band.
Is that, like, the ladies were always at Much. And, you know, we used to say, oh, you know, what day is it? Well, it's the Barenaked Ladies are here. It's Wednesday. Of course, they're here. And I think it was such an amazing time back then because we were sort of partners in everybody's success, right? It's like, right, Big C you come in, and Jim Cuddy you come in, and the Parents You Club would come in. And it wasn't like we were the media broadcaster exploiting the artists. It was like, we're so all in this together, and we were overjoyed when songs hit the charts and they could tour and put enough gas in the van and see you next Wednesday. Yeah.
We still appreciate it, Denise. Yeah. Thank you.
And all the people had to leave their desks so we could turn it into a stage in the studio.
Totally. Yeah. There were some things you left in some of those drawers, as I understand.
Sandwiches,
you know, foundation garments, as
foundation.
I recall. Yeah.
Foundation garments. That's
people would be like, what's in my desk? I don't know. All the ladies were here.
Speaking of early days, look who else is here. Yvonne Matzell is here.
Yvonne Matzell's here.
Yvonne Matzell was the first person in Toronto to book Barenaked Ladies for a residency at her Ultrasound Show Bar Club.
Hi, Yvonne.
Hi, darling. And that's why you got all those bands at Much Music, because we were next door neighbors, practically.
Yeah. Influence. Influence.
Nice to see you, Yvonne.
Just so you guys know, Yvonne does a different accent every time you talk to her. The British one is cool. I like that.
What are you going to play now?
We are going to, I don't know. Oh, Kev's going to sing one for you.
Kevin Hearn, everybody.
This is from our new record, Fake Nudes. It's called The Township of King. She lived alone in a little home by the Township of King. In the morning she'd feed the birds and listen to them sing. From the woods they flocked to her, knowing she would do no harm. Flying over the patchwork quilt of the fields and the farms.
As you wish, whatever's next.
Right. It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Cocked your head on the side and said I'm angry. 5 days since you laughed at me. Saying get that together, come back and see me. 3 days since the living room. I realized it's not my fault, but couldn't tell you yesterday. You've forgiven me, but it'll still be 2 days till I say I'm sorry.
Holding now my muscle hood wink, cause I make you stop think. Think you're looking at Aquaman. Some of fish to the dish, although I like Chinese, just I like to sushi. Never touch a frying pan, hot like wasabi when I bust rhymes. Speak like Leanne rhymes. It's all about value. Bert Camford's got the mad hits. Trying to match wits. Trying to hold me, but I bust through. Gonna make a break and take a fake. I like a stinking and get checking like vanilla. Finest for the flavors. See the jokers and you know the verdict. I was gonna focus until Dino Reese and I'm sign a waiver. Can't help it if I think you're funny when you're mad. Trying hard not to smile, though I feel bad. I'm the kind of guy who laughs at a funeral. Can't understand what I mean, well, you soon will. Have a tendency to wear my mind on my sleeve. Have a history of taking off my shirt.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Threw your arms to the air and said you're crazy. 5 days since you tackled me. I still got the weapons on both my knees. Been 3 days since the afternoon. I realized it's not my fault, no moment too soon. Yesterday, you've forgiven me. And now I sit back and wait till you say you're sorry.
jam is amplified, so just glide and let your backbone slide. Yes, 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 yeah. How's everybody feeling? You listen to every word I say, every verb you heard I play, snaps a vertebrae. You try to cover or hover me, you roast, I fake a flag, then I run a post, toast, I'm the most. DEF's how it goes, no X's or O's or tic-tac-toes, LTD knows. This ain't a game, I'm on a mission. Call me a hip-hop tic-tac-tician. A rapper's like a slab of clay, the shapeless. Champagne don't shimmer, no glass is tasteless. A universe without light is lightless. That's why I always take time to write this. Molded in my hands before I start chiseling. Could be a rain or brainstorm or drizzling. Sun could be shining, sun could be showering. Practice makes perfect, I'm powering, flowering. My lyrics are awesome and tune in, volume and bloom, and I'm blossoming. Blowing away blockades, the barricades, make it black and blue from the blast of the blade. It's a blood sport, blood bills I bang. Make your vision go blurry while your brain goes blank into oblivion. Beach from box to box of base, rocks for blocks and blocks. Let your backbone slide. Give it up for Maestro Fresh West. China, the Chinese chicken, chickity China, the Chinese chicken, chickity China, the Chinese chicken, chickity China, the Chinese chicken. Have a drumstick, ring stop sticking, watch the next files and no lights on. We are done, the lights on. But the smoking method this one, like Harrison Ford, I'm getting frantic. This thing I'm 10 trick, sneak is guaranteed to satisfy. The crew is how I make mad films, can I make films? But did it have a samurai? He had a set of better cups and when they come, I tiny them to some irons on, always fly to the backswing. Get into my seven book, cause I got tunas, got the blue anime, babe. So maybe think the wrong thing. Can't help it if I think you're funny when you're mad. Trying hard not to smile, though I feel bad. I'm the kind of guy who laughs at a funeral. Can't understand what I mean, but you soon will. Have a tendency to win my mind on the sleeve. Have a history of losing my shirt. 1 week since you looked at me. Come to run to the side and said I'm sorry. 5 days since I laughed at you and said you just did just what I thought you were gonna do. 3 days since the living room. I realize I want to blame, but what could we do? It'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. It'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. It'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. Richmond Stadium, home of the Robbie. Attracting more brothers than Kennedy Station.
Give it up for the legend, Maestro Fresh West.
Awesome.
That was a thrill, man. When Symphony Effect came out, I was driving all over Southern Ontario to see him play. I drove and saw him in Waterloo. I saw him in London. Saw him in Toronto. It was so cool. Oh, man. So it changed everything. That record put Canada on the map for hip hop.
Yeah, you know, Denise was saying, you know, while you were playing, not that she wasn't listening to the music,
listening intently,
but that, you know, previously Canadian bands didn't really make Canadian references. We hear Drake doing that now, but you guys did that. You referenced your own city and referenced your own neighborhood.
Well, and plus, you know, with Maestro and with Dream Warriors, and there were so many cool like things that you'd never really heard before. You
Michi
know?
Me,
and
then, the legendary Michi
Me, of course.
She's here.
Another legend in the house. And what I was going to say, though, is, you know, right after that, we had the explosion of Tribe and De La, and people were like, we never heard this before. And in Canada, we were like, well, we have. So anyway, amazing time. And now we're going to have Fred back, right? Fred, would you join us on one? Fred Penner, everybody. How do you sleep with so many legends in your home all the time?
I can't sleep when you're not here. That's the problem. That's why I keep bringing you back.
Where are you headed tonight? We gotta go sing Georgia bedtime song.
Our rates are reasonable, George.
Put it on my tab.
Recorded and thrown in for free.
That's right.
This is a song of Fred Penner's called If I Had $1 Million.
Thank you.
If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you a house.
I would buy you a house.
If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
I'd buy you furniture for your house.
A nice Chesterfielder and ottoman.
If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you a cake car.
A nice reliant automobile.
If I had $1 million.
I'd buy your love.
Just hang out there and just pester Fred for the filthiest, nastiest rock and roll stories. It's not that kind of show. I bet you it became that kind of show occasionally, though.
It's only a matter of time. It starts with a log.
If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you a fur coat.
But not a real fur coat, that's cruel.
If I had $1 million.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you an exotic pet.
Yes, like a llama or an emu.
If I had $1 million. I'd buy you John Merrick's remains.
All those crazy elephant bones.
If I had $1 million,
I'd buy your love. If I had $1 million, we wouldn't have to walk to the store. If I had $1 million, we'd take Fred's car because it costs more. If I dollars. We wouldn't have to eat crab dinner,
but we would
anymore.
Folks, being an audience member is not a passive thing. Yeah! Right now, you guys gotta sing for George's supper. Just repeat after me. Here we go. Everybody sing.
If I had $1 million.
That's it.
Well, I'd buy you a green dress.
But
not a real green dress, that's cruel.
If I had $1 million. Sing it.
If I had $1 million.
Well, I'd buy you some art.
A Picasso or a Garfunkel.
If I had $1 million. Come on.
Success. Everybody expects unlikely outcomes, and I'm just somewhere in the mess.
It's not an underdog sensation or a movie of the week. And anybody involved from the beginning knows it's not just a lucky streak. We're bringing it home forever after. It's in our bones. Hey, stay at the house, 'cause we're bringing it home. Oh, we raise the rafters. We made Rome. Hey, we packed it up and we're bringing it home. It's not a simple rite of passage where you just follow every step. Somebody took every single road map and there just wasn't any left. So we found our own direction, made our way to everyone. And now I look back on every misstep, wonder how we got it done. But we're bringing it home forever. Slicking, making slack jaws, last of the last straws. Slipping till the ice saw, swimming when it's ice cold. Brimming with the big bowl, flavor never waver. With the life and the life save, never ever let down. Good to get down, freaky like I'm Piggy D. I'm gonna make it my clown. All's well that ends well, glad like I'm glad well. Days off of days in, put my 10Ks in.
Change for you at all in the way you approach the studio?
It's similar, I think. I think Ed, you've been doing some co-writes with other people outside of the band recently, which is cool. But also in this latest one, Kevin Ed started doing some stuff. Like Kev completed a few bridges for Ed's songs, and it sort of morphs. There's been records where it's been like we've done, the band has come up with a groove and Steve and Ed went and wrote over top of it. And, yeah. But it's still kind of, it starts with simple, like one guy or two guys coming to the band. You got the lyrics, you got, you know, an idea of the chords and the melody, and then we take it from there.
One of my favorite stories ever is the way in which If I Had $1 Million was written, which was, Ed was a camp counselor, right? A day camp counselor. He would ride the bus to and from camp with the kids. He'd bring his guitar, and he just started playing this game with them, If I Had $1 Million. And
it was really just to keep them occupied because it was a long bus ride. So I just made up stuff about like what happened at camp. So that the start of the song was, If I Had $1 Million. And then I'd have all them sing, If I Had $1 Million, I'd buy you a hat because you dropped yours in the outhouse. And then everyone would laugh because that actually happened, you know? So it became a song to just sum up the camp day. And then I said to Steve, I wrote this song that I think could be really fun. And that was the genesis.
So can you imagine if you're a camp counselor in the iPad and iPhone era, you don't even have to keep them occupied. You never would have written that song.
It's true. It's true.
You'd be completely screwed. We didn't talk about this last time because you're your own band now, but we're looking back, the Steven thing, like looking back now at this Hall of Fame stuff. And it's, so now you get to revisit some of these stories with him again. What's that been like?
You know, I thought, I was sort of freaked out by it at first because, you know,
cue freaked out piano chord.
It's been almost 10 years.
Yeah,
right?
That's what I mean. It's a new bed.
And so I did, I stressed about it a little bit. And then I realized there's no point in stressing about this. This is an amazing thing. Yeah. It's a huge honor. And I'll get over my own, like, you know, inner struggles about it. And I'm just going to enjoy it. Like, we played with Steve for 20 years.
Right.
We wrote some of my favorite songs together. We did some of my favorite things ever, you know. So there's a lot of water under the bridge since then. And I'm looking forward to just having a really fun weekend and celebrating with our friends.
Well, and I love the fact that, I mean, when you're 10 years in this incarnation, it's a different thing. It's another identity that you got to write, and another. It sets the stage for what you do next. Does the band have an idea or a plan of what 10 or 15 years looks like?
From now?
Yeah.
I think Ed needs to get that camp counselor job back and write a few more
hits. I can dream, Kev. I can dream. But honestly,
you got Big Bang Theory. You don't need any more hits. Right.
You know, we're not just in a new chapter now. Like, we're many chapters post that, you know? So it's going to be fun to revisit everything that was great about that. And, you know, it caps off a really nice couple of years for us. We've been working really hard. And this is as I say, it's a very nice signpost in the road.
And fake.
Bring on the next 20.
Right.
You know, that's what I say. We'll keep doing this till we physically can't. Which may be next week sometime, but we'll keep doing it.
I mean, fake nudes in and of itself is worthy of another couple of decades, just having that word, that phrase.
For sure. So we were done now, but then a good friend of ours, an old friend, came by because we actually sent an email out to him to say, hey, would you want to do this with us? And we never heard his response. And then he just showed up. And he may know the song better than we do because I think he learned it. He spent some time learning it, but we haven't played it in a long time. So Chris Murphy from Sloan is here. It was going everything went great. And now we're going to do this thing. We don't know how it's going to go.
We did no rehearsal. It'll be fine. And and you guys all know it, so please chime in. It's so fast. It's hard.
It's really fast.
We just fretted about it.
That's it's you fretted, right?
Yeah.
Fretless over here.
All right.
A one, a two, a one, two, three.
Come on.
Lost my lunch and I broke my glasses.
That guy is huge.
The girl is wailing.
First day of school and I'm already failing. This is me in grade 9, baby. This is me in grade 9.
This is me in grade 9,
baby. This is me in grade 9. I got a blue and red Adidas bag and a humongous binder. I try my best not to look like a minor niner. When I follow football team to prove that I'm a man, I guess I should. This is me in grade 9, baby, yeah.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me, you guys.
Chris Murphy, Maestro Fresh West, Fred Penner.
Missionary.
Barenaked Ladies.
Yes, to the Strombo Show. Stay in the lovely bedroom downstairs, right next to George's shower. It's supposed to be the story.
Better than us. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for coming. Drop the needle.
Thank you. All right, we're done. Thank you.
That's right.
Thank you. Thank you.